Now the Bible says the spirit of the prophet, the subject of the prophet. If he was God called and God sent, then he'd love me. And he would be right with me, obeying what I tell him. Because God has given it to me. But he wants to be smart. He wants to advertise himself. Well, I'm going to help advertise him. Amen. And when I get through advertising him, everybody will know he's a fool. Now, here's what he said. He condemned, and I want you to mark this down and come right on behind me. Now, don't evade these questions. I know you're listening. Yes, I recorded you. My studio recorded you last Sunday. I'm going to record you today, too. Because I'm going to keep after you until you give Bible, or else tell the public that you didn't know what you're talking about and you told a lie. Since you say you're a Bible man, you believe in the Bible, I want you to give us Bible today that Nimrod went out hunting souls. You said that. You said that. Now you give us Bible for it since you a Bible man, I'll get rid of it real quick and tell the public that they say, well, I told a lie. I didn't know what I was talking about. Because if you don't, I'm going to keep on asking. Now, don't evade it. Don't jump around it. You give Bible since you said Nimrod was out hunting souls. You don't know nothing. Because there wasn't no preachers in that dispensation. Yeah, me now, I'm going to outline it to kick my whole house. Amen. I'm going to kill you. It was no preacher, and if he had, he went out hunting, so when he found him, he couldn't have said nothing to them. Because God hadn't told him to say nothing to nobody.
Amen.
You didn't know that that was a dispensation in which everybody done as he pleased, walked by his own conscience.
Right.
He done as he pleased. There was nothing given to folk to commanding them to do. Now hear me and follow me. In the first dispensation, which was a dispensation of innocence, God did tell even Adam what to do. In the second dispensation, which Noah built the ark, there was something for folks to do to save their lives, and that was to go in the ark. But the third dispensation, which was a human government dispensation, it wasn't told to folks to do, it didn't tell them to do nothing. Everybody walked by his own conscience, and Paul spoke about it in the 14th chapter of Acts of the Apostles, when the people wanted to do sacrifice to them, and that it was a time that God permitted all men to walk after his own way.
Right.
That was the time that the human government dispensation, that's the time God permitted folks to walk after their own way. There was no preacher. There was no preacher in the human government dispensation. There was no preacher in Abraham's day. That's the reason God Almighty took the place of the preacher himself in the post-dispensation. God took the place of the preacher and met Abraham, while Abraham took the place of the congregation. Abraham paid tithing to God, and God fed Abraham bread and wine. So it was no priest, no preacher. The priest arose from Aaron, come from Levi. I know you didn't know that. That's too deep for you. That Nimrod is out hunting souls. You told a lie. Now you straighten that lie up or give us Bible for it. Now don't evade it. Now you hear good. I want you to work on these as I give them to you.
Yes.
This is your homework.
Amen.
You're so smart. This is your homework. Now you give Bible where Nimrod went out hunting souls, and then I'll be the liar. Now you condemn the people standing up when I come in. I'm going to read the 31st chapter of Exodus. I'm going to read the 8th verse. I believe it's the 8th verse. And let us see now what you're going to do about this. You condemn it, not knowing the Bible. All right, read.
And it came to pass when Moses went out unto the tabernacle.
It came to pass when the man of God went out unto the tabernacle.
That all the people rose up.
That all the people rose up, every last one.
And stood.
And
every man at his tent door.
And stood every man at his tent door.
And looked at the moon.
And watched Moses.
Until
God's name.
Going into the tabernacle.
Until he walked into the tabernacle. Now you condemn that. Now you tell the public this morning that I didn't know what I was talking about. I didn't know that was written. Now that's number two. Number three is Leviticus 17th chapter and the 13th verse. You condemn me, honey. You condemn me, honey. All right. We're going to read.
And whatsoever man there be of the children of Israel.
And whatsoever man there be, listen now, whether he's a preacher or whatever kind of man he is.
Amen.
Whatsoever man there be of the children of Israel.
Or of the strangers.
Or sinners.
That sojourn among you.
That sojourn among you.
Which hunteth.
Oh.
Which hunteth. And catches any beast or fowl that may be eaten.
Catch a deer or catch a pheasant.
Yes.
Any beast or fowl that may be eaten.
He shall even pour out the blood thereof.
You don't tell him to hunt.
No.
Don't condemn him for hunting.
No.
Don't say it's wrong to hunt whatsoever, man. And that gets me too.
Amen.
That hunteth.
Yes.
I'm going to put you to the wall. I'm going to let you know how to jump on Bishop Johnson.
Amen.
Amen. Listen what the Bible says. Now, you condemn, honey. The Bible don't condemn it. All right.
Whatsoever man there be of the children of Israel.
Whatsoever man there be of the children of Israel.
Or of the strangers.
That means the saints. We are the children of Israel. We are Israelites by faith.
Amen.
Amen. All right.
That sojourn among you.
That sojourn among you.
Which hunteth. And catcheth any beast or fowl that may be eaten.
Any beast or fowl that he can eat.
He shall even pour out the blood thereof.
Just pour the blood out on the ground, because that's the life of all flesh.
Covered
with dust.
And that is the life of all flesh.
It's the life of all flesh. All right. Give me the 27th chapter of Genesis. And again at the first verse. I want to show you the public that you're a liar and you don't know nothing. You don't know anything. All right.
And it came to pass when Isaac was old and his eyes were dim so that he could not see.
Yeah.
He called Esau his eldest son and said unto him.
This is one of the patriarchs. Condemning. All right, read.
My son.
My son.
And he said unto him, behold, here I am.
Yeah.
And he said, behold, now I'm old.
Yeah.
I know not the day of my death.
I don't know the day of my death.
Now, therefore, take, I pray thee, thy weapon.
Get your weapon. Get your gun. Get whatever you kill with.
Thy quiver.
Uh-huh.
And thy bow.
Yeah.
And go out to the field.
And go out in the field.
And take me some venison.
Yeah, go hunting. And get me a deer.
Amen.
I want to have some good deer meat to eat before I die.
Amen.
Go hunting, my boy.
Amen.
You condemn it. You condemn it. Now, you condemn this, Marty. Now let your little ignoramus holler amen on this. Now you mark them down now. This is number 3 I'm dealing with.
Yes.
All right.
And make me favor me.
Yeah.
With such as I love.
Such as I love.
And bring it to me.
And bring it to me.
I mean,
yeah.
That my soul may bless thee before I die.
Yeah. Now you told a lie. I'm not through with that. You told a lie and says Esau lost his birthright out hunting. You misapplied the scripture. He didn't lose his birthright because he was hunting. He didn't lose his birthright. I want you to give us Bible now that because he hunted, he lost his birthright. He has misapplying the Bible. All right, read on.
And Rebekah heard when Isaac spake to Esau his son.
Yes.
And Esau went to the field to hunt for venison and bring it.
He went to the field to hunt. He went to the field to hunt for a deer.
Yes.
And he got one, I believe.
And to bring it.
And to bring it.
And Rebekah spake unto Jacob her son.
Now, that's all I wanted at, but that's your number 3. Now, you get right on this. Don't start that beating around the bush and offsetting and talking about this, that, and the other. Here's your homework.
That's right.
And you get right on that. Now, he goes to work to say that a man cannot be saved. You don't know nothing about the Bible. You said a man cannot be saved unless he's baptized in water in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost. Nobody can be saved. Because Jesus said, except a man is born again of the water and spirit, he cannot enter. That's true. And all the rest is true. But you're not able to rightly divide the word of God. You don't know there's 3 types of people. There's one type of class is going up and meet Jesus in the midair. There's another class is not going up. When they go, they're going to still stay in the grave. That's the bride going up. But the old patriarchs and all of the old super, amen, prophets and all, they're not going up in the bride. They're going to come up in the first at the end of the first resurrection. In other words, they're going to complete the first resurrection after Jesus going to midnight with the bride and stay there approximately 3.5 years. And when he comes back to the earth, then the Old Testament saints and the tribulation saints is going to come up and going to complete the first resurrection. You didn't know that. Amen. Now then, that's why John says he saw the soul of them that was beheaded crying out from under the altar, saying, "How long, O Lord, will you not avenge our blood upon them that dwell on the earth?" And white robes were given them and told them to wait for a little season until their brother will be killed like them. That is the tribulation saint. Now the tribulation saint is not baptized in water in Jesus' name, and they're not going to be talking in tongues. But they're going to come up at the when Jesus comes back from the mid-air and going to complete the first resurrection. That's class two. Now give me Revelation, if you please, the 20th chapter, and I believe I want the 12th verse. Now let us hear this.
"And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God."
Oh, here come another class now. You didn't know that, did you? Here come another class. Another class is coming up. And John said, "I saw what? The dead,
small and great, stand before God."
Now, these not the ones that went up in midair standing before God. Neither are these the ones that the tribulation saints standing before God. Not in either one of these. But here's another group coming. You didn't know that, did you? You little smart would-be 16th of an inch by an eighth of an inch. Self-sense creature, don't know nothing. No wonder you wouldn't stand before me. You wouldn't last as long as a gnat would last in a tornado. Amen. All right.
"And I saw the dead, small and great." "Stand before God."
Now, bear in mind, public. Bear in mind, my listeners. I've got three classes of people here. One class went up. For Paul says, "The Lord himself shall ascend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ is going to rise first. And they that remain is going to be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, and caught up to meet the Lord in the air." That's class number one. That's the one that is baptized in water in Jesus' name and got the Holy Ghost talking in tongues. My God, they are in the bride, and they're going on up there to meet him in the midair. But the Old Testament says, praise God, is still in the dust with their souls crying out from under the altar, waiting for the tribulation saint that is going to lose their head before they take the mark of the beast. Amen. And they, praise God, is going to fall in the street and going to stay there. And they're right at 3.5 days, which represents 3.5 years. And when the Lord comes down, then they're going to be resurrected with the Old Testament saints and going to join the bride. But here's another class coming on.
Amen.
Hallelujah to God. Yeah, well, it's all right. Yeah. I know what I'm talking, but you don't know this. Here's another class, and old John talking about the last class. Hear me now. Read.
And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God.
I saw the kings of the earth. I saw the dog catchers. I saw everything that died standing before God.
And the book rolls.
And the book. Listen now. You said nobody going to get into heaven but them baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost. These folks then baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Some of these people are righteous people, and the righteous comes under judgment. Amen now. The righteous comes under judgment. See? You didn't know that. Amen. All righteous got to come under judgment, because John says, "Blessed and holy is he." It's the 5th verse, isn't it? Or the 6th verse.
Blessed and holy is he.
And have part in the first resurrection. Did you hear that now? Now the first resurrection is the Holy Ghost. Baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
But you didn't know that. See, you didn't know that. You don't know nothing. Amen. That's the class number one. Blessed and holy is he that has part in the first resurrection.
Once such a second death.
Yes, now the first resurrection is when the Lord coming to meet us and the folk that is here alive, living holy, and them in the dust, praise God, that died holy, baptized in the same river of the Holy Ghost, they're going up and meet the Lord in the air and going up in the twinkling of an eye.
Amen.
But all everybody isn't saved yet.
Amen.
They're going to come on now, praise God, and get the Old Testament saints and the tribulation saints that is going to start during the tribulation before they take the mark of the beast.
Amen.
And they're going to join the bride. And here's another group after the 1,000 years of this time.
Yeah.
He's going to be here on earth 1,000 years after the first resurrection is completed. He's going to be here 1,000 years. Don't you hear John talking, bless God, in the first of this chapter, that I saw an angel come down from heaven, and then having a key of the bottom of the pit, and a great chain in his hand, and a great hole on that dragon, the serpent, which is the devil, and Satan, and bound him 1,000 years. What is that 1,000 years? During the time Jesus is down here on the earth with his bride. But the wicked and the righteous is still in the dark, waiting until the 1,000 years will be expired.
Yeah.
When the 1,000 years is expired, then Satan is going to be loose out of his prison for a little season. And it's going about to gather together God and mingle. That's the end of the 1,000 years. That's the end of the 1,000 years. John said, now it's time for judgment.
Amen.
And I saw the dead,
fallen
and good,
and the book
of
and the book was open.
And the book was open.
Amen. And another book was open.
Amen. Don't bother me, whatever you do. You ought to know better. Amen. John says, saw the dead,
fallen and great.
Stand
before God.
And the books were open.
And the books was open.
And another book was open.
Which is the book of life.
Which is up here, some folk going into the kingdom now. That isn't baptized in Jesus' name. And then you have the Holy Ghost talking in his tongue. He that said, blessed is that servant when the Lord cometh, shall find so doing. If you've been baptized in water in the name of Jesus Christ, and at the altar of God it in your heart and seeking God with your whole heart, amen, Jesus said, blessed.
Yeah.
Is that servant, didn't mean cursed in that servant, but blessed.
Yeah.
And if you're blessed, then you're saved.
Yeah.
For your hand said, come and blessed,
amen,
into the kingdom. You don't know how to connect Bible. You don't know nothing about it. But a hymn said, come and bless it.
Yes.
And he said himself out of his own mouth, bless it.
Bless it.
Is that servant,
yes,
when his Lord comes,
yes,
shall find doing what his Lord told him to do.
Amen.
So the Lord said, repent and be baptized,
yes,
every one of you, and carry on faith.
Amen.
And if you repent of your sin and baptize in Jesus' name,
yes,
and tarrying when the Lord comes, the Lord said, bless it.
Amen.
Is that servant.
Yes.
And when it said, bless it, I hear him talking to the blessed,
yes,
that come ye blessed.
Amen.
Into the kingdom,
amen,
that is prepared for you.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Amen. I want to show you something. All right.
And yeah. I saw the dead small and great.
Stand
before God.
And the book was open.
And another book was open.
Which is the book of life.
And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the book.
Now listen now, And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the book.
According to their word.
And the sea gave up the dead which were in it.
And death and hell delivered up the dead which were in it.
But would be found right. That's why God's going to have judgment. Amen. Now listen what the Bible says. Now read.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. And whosoever was not found written. In the book of life.
There was nobody going to be saved. There wouldn't be no book of life there.
Amen.
You hear me? Now, whosoever was not found in the, written in the book of life
was
cast into the lake of fire. That's why God is going to have the white throne judgment, because the people, some people, was believed in right and had done all the right they knew. Amen. And whenever any man starts to doing right, stops his sinning and doing right, then he comes on in the righteous class. And he's subject for judgment. And when God judges and finds him righteous, he's going to be saved. Give me 1 Peter 4:18. Amen. You don't know anything about the gospel, and I'm going to work on you forever.
Amen.
Now, you answer these questions. Don't evade them. Just come on and tell us. Answer one by one. And that's number four, I think I gave you that. All right, read.
And if the righteous scarcely be saved,
Peter didn't say that the righteous wouldn't be saved. Peter didn't say, wouldn't it, nobody going to get in the kingdom of them baptized Jesus ain't got the Holy Ghost, because he knew that.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost moved on Peter, and Peter says, yes,
if the righteous
scarcely be, they'll be saved,
yes.
But it'll be scarcely.
Amen.
But they'll be saved.
Amen.
Amen. All they want to do is get in.
Yes.
But if the righteous, now this is God's word talking.
Yes.
You the Bible man, you said. Now tell the public this is a lie, or tell them you're a lie.
Yes.
One of the two. Now mark that down and don't forget it now. Tell him this, that scripture is a lie. Or either say, I'm a lie.
Yes.
One of the two now. I don't want no beating around the bush. You went to work and this offset the scripture said that which was written four times. You said Peter and Paul didn't hunt. Now I want you to get in the Bible. The Bible says this. Speak that you do know.
Yes.
You testify that you see.
Yes.
How do you know they didn't hunt?
Amen.
How do you didn't know that in her? It was a privilege.
Amen.
Because the Old Testament permitted it.
Amen.
And the New Testament didn't condemn it.
Amen.
It was a privilege to her. How you know that in her?
Amen.
The Bible says, speak that you do know and testify that you have seen. The way you went in Romans, not knowing what you're talking about, that a thing is written a full time and written for our learning. That is, if Peter and Paul had a hundred, it would have been written. The Bible wasn't written to write up Peter and Paul's natural activity.
Amen.
Which was written a full time and written for us to be saved by.
Amen.
Not what Peter and Paul done naturally.
Amen.
The word of God wasn't for that. That shows how much you know. That shows how much you know. You try to hide, but I'm going to blast you out from there.
Amen.
Amen. You can't hide there. What was written full time, written for our learning. God, what God wanted us to learn about salvation was written.
Amen.
That's what was written, what God wanted us to learn about salvation.
Amen.
So we could rejoice in the thing that was written.
Amen.
But about Peter and Paul's natural activities, why the Bible didn't record that, it wasn't written for that.
Amen.
Amen. So now I want you to give Bible where they didn't hunt. They didn't hunt. How you know they didn't hunt?
Amen.
If you had a lesson alone and said, well, I don't know whether they hunted or not, then you'd have been right. But you went away and said they didn't hunt.
Amen.
How you know? Tell me now how you know they didn't hunt. Don't run to Roman because that wasn't talking about their natural activity.
Amen.
Amen. Talking about the spiritual activities of God.
Amen.
It spoke about Peter and Paul's spiritual activity.
Amen.
But not their natural activity.
Amen.
I have a natural activity. Amen. But when my spiritual activity comes on, I've got to come back to the Bible.
Amen.
Now you tell it. Amen. Or else be a little liar. All right. Now, I hope you got all of this, amen, and you're talking about the faith. Now, I want you to tell me from what you say a debate has got to be first-hand. That's your mouth. Give me Bible before I say it must be first-hand. Give me Bible for it now. That a debate must be first-hand. Give me Bible for it. You say you a Bible man. If you read that in the Bible, that a debate must be first planned, then we'll have to fix it.
Amen.
If you don't read it today, now you'll be the liar. And the public is listening. They're marking it down. They're listening and expecting you to come on now and answer.
Yes.
All of these questions that I ask, and if you don't, I'm coming right back next Sunday.
Amen.
And I'm going to blast you until you're hurt forever.
Amen.
Amen. Now, you tell me, what does a debate derive from? An argument? Here's your part. You said Paul didn't debate. Paul disputed and argued. And you said that's not a debate. Paul didn't debate. And in order to make your lie true, then you got to say that the argument and dispute is not a debate. A debate must be planned. Now, you tell me, what is a debate? Is it an agreement or is it a disagreement? Just tell me now. Now, the saints had a debate among themselves, that's right.
Yes.
But was it agreement that caused the debate?
Yes.
Or was it a disagreement or an argument? Just tell me, was it a disagreement? Then you want Bible for everything. I'm going to come on to the Bible now.
Yes.
The Bible talks about a debate.
Yes.
Now, you tell me, what did that debate that the Bible spoke about in among the saints,
yes,
what did it derive from? Tell us that today. Be sure to tell us now. Was it an argument between them, or was they agreeing all on one thing? And if it was an argument, then it was a debate. Amen. If it was a disagreement, then you got to pick sides. The Bible called it a debate. But if it was an agreement, then you give us Bible that it was an agreement. They come together and all of them agreed on the same thing, and that was a debate. You're lazy and saying you don't know anything, and you come bothering me. You ought to know better, don't you know? It's not a man under the sun living, walking in shoe leathers, able to stand before me. Don't you know it's not a man living nowhere in the world, walking in shoe leather, barefooted, is able to stand before Bishop S.C. Johnson? And all of the preachers, hear me, all of them is hiding, praise God, and you'll be hiding soon. Yeah. Amen. If you don't, you'll be a mighty big fool. Amen. What I'm preaching is of God. Amen. I've called of God and Son of God to preach the truth of God. And I defy the world to contradict what I say. Amen. Now you got them all marked down. Don't evade them. Don't jump around and read some other scripture. We want you to pick up one by one and answer them one by one and give Bible. Condemn before standing when I come. Give Bible where Nimrod went out hunting souls. Give Bible against hunting. Give Bible where nobody will be saved but them baptized water in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, and then condemn all these other scriptures. Condemn 1 Peter 4:18, that the righteous guest will be saved. Amen. You didn't know there were three classes of people, praise God, is going into this thing. You didn't know that because God didn't send you. God hasn't sent you to do nothing. And you got a job, you ought to stay on that job and do a good job and come and sit down here and let me teach you the word of God. Amen. And everybody got to hear you. Well, God help the people have to hear your lies. Amen. Everybody got to hear you. Well, God put it low. Amen. Amen. You don't know what you're talking about. Amen. And I don't know you. If I met you, I wouldn't know you. Why bother me? Folks told me about me, I wouldn't kill time with you until it got serious, and I can always kick them eye in.
Amen.
Amen. Now, don't forget now, we'll be listening for this. I've wasted a good hour almost on you, but I don't mind. Amen. I'll waste many more. I'm going to get you. I'll stop the mouth of all other opponents, and I'll stop your mouth. Now, don't forget, folks, to be out tomorrow night and see me stop this Mr. Pemberton's mouth. And all that come with it, I'm going to stop him, and I'll stop him, I'll stop him. If I don't stop him, I'll give him a movement. I'll be his servant forever. God never told nobody to remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy in this distance. All right, now we got a few letters here.
Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Here, this is
I remember I'm here all the week, all day and all the week. Washington, I didn't get a vision. And that dream I won't be with you tonight. I didn't get a vision last night. But I'll be back with you soon. Amen. I'll be back with you soon, and we'll be in Norfolk, Virginia, Ellen Mills. I hope you'll call me up after this broadcast. I got something very important to say to you. We'll be in Norfolk, Virginia soon, and we'll be in Richmond, Virginia. You folks in Richmond that have been fighting, we'll be there to answer all questions. Let Richmond know it's only one thing, and I have that. People want to know about am I on the only man. Amen. Am I the only man? Well, one man has got to tell the world this. Yeah. You didn't know that? You didn't know that? Give me the 11th chapter of Hebrews and read the 7th verse, and then I'm going to get away. I wish I had time to enlarge on this. Amen. We're going to have to get away from letters. I'm full of preach. I want to preach now these days. Amen. We're going to have to get away from letters on all these birthdays and different things and preach the word of God. Amen. We'll have to do that because that's what I'm on the air for. Praise God, I want to preach. I can dig up the Bible, you know. Amen. I'm able to do it. God give it to me. Amen. And of course, when God give a man a thing, he's got that. You know that? When God give anything a thing, he's got that.
Amen.
And God give me the gospel.
Amen.
And I have it, and I'm the one to preach it. Yes, I'm the one man.
Amen.
Amen. That is all through the Bible, one man. All right, this.
By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world.
By the which Noah condemned the world. Now, who did God tell it was going to destroy the world? How many did it tell?
Only one man.
Didn't tell nobody but Noah. And Noah had everybody else to tell. So God has told me, and I got to tell everybody else.
Amen.
So you want to know about one man having it? That one man had it there.
Who did God tell is going to serve God and Jamaat?
Lot.
How many?
One man.
Huh? How many that was in Ahab's day when Jehoshaphat asked him, was the prophet of the Lord? He said, there's one man here. One. And then the Ahab by whom we may inquire. How many?
One.
And you got one now. Bishop Johnson.
Amen.
And the world has got to hear me. Tell you got one now. Amen. And Bishop S.C. Johnson is his name. At 22nd and Bainbridge Street. And are you going to church today?
Amen.
You're going to church today. Don't amount to a neck scratching up Allegheny Mountain.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Because if you're not baptized in water in Jesus' name and have the baptism of the Holy Ghost, you would have done amount to nothing.
Amen.
And any church that is operating that don't believe in water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ according to the Bible, not according to my mouth,
amen,
but according to the Bible, getting the Holy Ghost speaking in other tongue that is bread of God give utterance, amen, then that's a false church. All of them are false. Everyone is false. You hear what I'm telling you? So don't you go to church. You stay home. I'm getting many letters of folks that are staying home. Who let that preacher go to work? God didn't send him to preach nothing. You know, he is baptized in water in Jesus' name. He don't have the baptism of the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. God didn't send him to preach nothing. He's out getting money, hunting money, and you're paying to go to hell. Stay home. Let him get a job too, and go to work, because the church of the Lord Jesus Christ started on the day of Pentecost at Jerusalem, where Jesus said it would start, where Isaiah said it would start, and they were baptized in Jesus' name. They were filled with the Holy Ghost. They spoke in other tongues, and the Spirit of God gave utterance, and that's where the church started. Now, every church that is operating today and don't even start or operate like that church started is a false church. And it's a false preacher. And he's a sinner. And I defy him to stand behind his gospel. I defy the world. They hear this. And nobody will show up and to do his own last. Come out today at 22nd Bainbridge tonight and tomorrow night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Thursday night, Friday night. Praise God, Saturday night and all day next Sunday. All right, come out and ask me questions,
yes,
preacher.
Yes.
Question me.
Amen.
See, can I answer? Amen. I'll answer the word. It's one thing, and Bishop Johnson has that. So don't worry about one name. Noah was one name. And I dare you to tell me God told anybody else.
Amen.
I dare you. In all the world, God come to one name and told one name.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
And when God told that one man, then he took what God said and rose up and condemned the world.
Amen.
That's what I'm doing.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It's one thing by which the world must be saved. Now my time is gone, as I said, I want to preach. Amen. I want to preach. I'm full of preach. I'm a Bible interpreter.
Yes,
yes I am.
Amen.
Bible interpreter can interpret the Bible, open it up, pick it apart, pick it to teach it, and defy anybody that contradicts what I say. Where I get that from? I got that from God. If I hadn't got it from God, I'd have been like all other false prophets. Amen. Now I'll be looking for you for an entire week. Amen. Write in some and let me hear from you. Amen. Condemn what I said. If you can, if you do, then I'll do yourself. Amen.
Let's go.
That is in mind, whatever I say. That's it. One plan of salvation, only plan. No other plan. Amen. Don't take two blueprints, different, and build one out. Do you? You know better than that. Amen. Brother Spicer knows he's a builder. He never used no two different blueprints and put up one building. I pray not tell them all they're liars. And I'm telling them publicly. Amen. I told them all down in Florida last Sunday. Praise God, and I had some folks to talk to, believe me. But I told them, don't drunk. I nobody drunk but a few fools, and they didn't drunk long. Amen. Nobody will make a fool of themselves. Because everybody that has got in a sound judgment knows that I know what I'm talking about. They know. So I'm telling you what. No use of nobody talking no more forever. No use of going to no church no more. Stay home. Don't want it. All right, let us stand.